Time for it.
Okay.
He's getting what?
He's getting a chair anyways.
Oh, okay.
Just text
211. Not a bomb, but it's a gym bag, Carl.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry for you. I'm sorry. You.
It's like calling a mandolin a ukulele. Good evening, everybody, and good evening to you. We're going to get started tonight. Let's all stand up. How's everybody? Is everybody good? Hey, we're in for a treat tonight, and we've brought all of our groups together. We're going to hear a report back from Emily about the great things that God's doing in different parts of the world and what he's done in her life. But before we hear her report or anything else, let's just turn our focus towards the Lord. Have you come to worship God tonight?
Amen.
All right, good, good. That's why we're here. And it's great to have Joy Renewed. It's great to have our youth. And I don't know, the rest of the crew. And so I would highly encourage integration. You know, that if you, at any point, youth, if you spontaneously feel like, I'd just like to sit next to somebody in this part over here, just get right up and go over and sit by them and worship next to them and whatever else. So anyways, they're not buying it, Naveen, at all. Not at all. Yes, there's a man, Christian. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So here we go. Let's... see, Max, I like it. Very, very well done. All right, let's pray, guys, and let's just turn our attention to the Lord. I don't know what your day is held today, but I know that God is mighty, that God is awesome. And this first song that we sing is Strength Will Rise as We Wait Upon the Lord. So let's do what the Bible says. Let's cast our cares on him. Let's turn our attention to Jesus, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And God, we do that now. Lord, we honor you in this place. This is a sanctuary, God, where we come out from the things that are so heavy in our lives, and we take a break, Lord, from the worries and the cares of this world, and we find ourselves in the presence of the living God. And so, Lord, we honor you. We welcome you, Holy Spirit. We bless your name. Would you do this? Would you just take a moment, and just in your own way, would you just honor God? Just speak blessing. Just speak out the names of God. Just begin to lift up your voices. Don't be shy about it. He's the King of Kings. He's the Lord of Lords. Come on, just let your faith begin to rise in our sanctuary here. God inhabits the praises of his people. That we're not ashamed of this gospel. It's the power of God. We worship you, Lord.
Strength will rise. Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. wait upon the Lord.
Sing it out. Strength will rise.
Strength will rise as we wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the our God. You reign forever. Our hope, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. You do not faint, you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles.
Strength arise.
Strength arise as we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord. Strength arises, we wait upon the Lord. We will wait upon the Lord. Wait upon the Lord. Our God, you reign forever. Our hope, our strong deliverer. You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. You do not faint, you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles.
The everlasting God.
You are the everlasting God. The everlasting God. You do not faint, you won't grow weary. You're the defender of the weak. You comfort those in need. You lift us up on wings like eagles.
And from everlasting, God, you are everlasting. And you lift us up on wings like eagles. Just clap to the Lord. You lift us up, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, perfect love is casting out fear. And even when I'm caught in the middle of the storms of this life, I won't turn back, I know you are near. And I will fear no evil, for my God is with me. And if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Then shall I fear? Oh no, you never let go through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go with every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go, Lord, you never let go. That is coming for the heart that holds on. Glorious light beyond all compare. There will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, when live to know you here on the earth, and I will fear no evil, for my God is with me, and if my God is with me, whom then shall I fear? Whom then shall I fear? Oh no, you never let go, through the calm and through the storm. Oh no, you never let go, with every high and every low. Oh no, you never let go, don't you never let go of me,
'cause I can see the light.
Well, I can see the light that is coming for the heart that holds on. There will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, still I will praise you, still I will praise you.
So I can see the light.
So I can see the light that is coming for the heart that holds on. There will be an end to these troubles, but until that day comes, still I will praise you, still I will praise you. Coming through the storm, oh no, you never let go, with every high, with every low. Oh no, you never let go, you never let go of me.
Sing it out.
Oh no, you never let go, through the calm and through the storm. You never let go, with every high and every low. No, you never let go, you never let go of me.
Praise you, Jesus.
And in the desert where I lost my way, in the raging sea, where I began to sink, I, yes, I choose to worship you. When all my failures overwhelm my soul, when my endless trials seem to steal my hope, I, yes, I choose to worship you.
And sing our promise. This I recall.
And this I recall. Therefore I hope the Lord's loving kindness never ceases, for his compassions never fail. So great is thy faithfulness, and right now I make my stand, praise your name with all that I am, and I, yes, I choose to worship you
in this hour.
In this hour, in this day, may this song declare all your ways, and I, yes, I choose to worship you.
Sing right now,
right now, I make my stand to praise your name. With all that I am, and I, yes, I choose to worship you
in this hour.
In this hour, in this day, may this song declare all your ways, and I, yes, I choose to worship you.
I worship you.
I worship you. I worship.
Your hands.
Empty-handed, but alive in your hands.
Majesty.
Singing majesty. Oh, majesty. Forever I am changed by your love. In the presence of your majesty,
majesty,
sing majesty, majesty. Your grace has found me just as I am, empty handed, but alive in your hands. Singing majesty, majesty. Forever I am changed by your love. In the presence of your majesty. Speak to me, lead me, be my voice. Speak to me, lead me, be my song. Speak to me, lead me, be my strength. Speak to me, lead me, be my life.
Speak to me.
Oh, speak to me, lead me, be my voice. Speak to me, lead me, be my song. Lord, speak to me, lead me, be my strength. Speak to me, lead me, be my life.
Speak to me.
Speak to me, lead me, be my voice. Speak to me, lead me, be my song. Just speak to me, lead me, be my strength. Oh, speak to me, lead me, be my life.
I'm desperate.
I'm desperate. I'm desperate. I'm desperate for you. I'm desperate. I'm desperate. I'm desperate for you.
Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. And all of my days, I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love.
My comfort, my shelter,
you're a
tower of refuge and strength. Let every breath
and all that I am,
all that I am, never cease to worship you.
So we shout to the Lord.
Shout to the Lord, all the earth, let us sing. Power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down and the seas will roar at the sound of your name. I sing for joy at the work of your hand. Forever I love you, forever I'll stand. 'Cause nothing compares to the promise I have in you.
It's my Jesus.
My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days, I want to praise the wonders of your mighty love. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength. So let every breath and all that I am never cease to worship you.
So we shout to the Lord.
Shout to the Lord. Let us sing. Power and majesty, praise to the King. Mountains bow down. sound of your name.
I sing for joy.
I sing for joy at the work of your hands. Forever I'll love you, forever I'll stand. Nothing compares to the promise I have.
Nothing compares.
Nothing compares to the promise I have.
Nothing compares.
Nothing compares to the promise I have in you.
Jesus, praise your name, God. Praise your name.
Lord, you're the vine and we're the branches, and God, we just choose to abide in you now. Can I just invite you? I know sometimes even in the middle of wanting to worship God, your mind can get distracted with all kinds of things. And can I just invite you here in this moment, just fix your gaze on Jesus, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, the one we sung about, majesty. The everlasting God, the lover of our soul, the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end, King Jesus. Just fix your gaze on him. And God, we focus our attention on you. Lord, we choose to take it off of ourselves and we place it upon you. We offer our lives as living sacrifices to you. And God, we ask that your healing touch would come over this place now. That the wonder of worship, God, where we are invited into the throne room of the living God, to fellowship with you, where you welcome us in by your grace. And we know that that place of your presence is a place where there is no sickness or disease or depression or issues that face us here today, but it's your kingdom. And God, we pray, let your kingdom come, let your will be done on earth as it already is in heaven. Give us a taste now, God. Give us a taste of your kingdom at work in our midst. God, I pray that over the hurting. I pray that over the broken. I pray that over the confused, over the depressed. Let your kingdom come. And Lord, as loyal and faithful servants to that kingdom, we do what you commanded us to do. We speak the authority of the name of Jesus, that in the name of Jesus, every demon spirit is bound. In the name of Jesus, every tormenting, lying spirit is cast out. That in the name of Jesus, there's healing and hope. Father, we pray against just a discouragement. We just speak hope in the name of Jesus. Hope to the hopeless, strength to the weary. Fill our cups, God, in your presence. There's fullness of joy. In your presence, God, there's fullness of joy. Thank you, God. Praise your name. Praise your name, Jesus. We have great things we're going to talk about tonight, and great things that are going to happen, but this is a moment that you don't want to miss now. This is a moment for you to just soak in the presence of God. Let Jesus minister to you. Just receive from God. Just receive from Him. How great is our God?
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God?
Declare His greatness. How great is our God?
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God?
Let's believe it even more, the greatness of our God. Sing it again, how great is our God?
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God? How great is our God? Well, sing with me, how great is our God? And all will see how great is our God.
Sing it again, how great is our God?
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God, and all will see how great is our God.
Will you clap to the Lord and just lift a shout of praise?
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise you, God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord. Hey, before you sit down, let's greet each other, but make it a holy thing, right? Let's just greet each other. Let's bless each other in the name of the Lord. Hello, hello. Hello.
All right, friends and countrymen. Could we get a little more, Randy? Just up a little.
Hello, hello. Hello, aloha. Oh.
It's a lightsaber. All right, everyone, let's grab our seats. Hey, as you're getting seated, I think that tonight we're streaming this, right? And so I'm almost certain that Katie and Brett are probably watching this. So everybody say hello to Katie and Brett, who are friends and members of Zion, just in the Washington church that we have there. No, Katie and Brett, hello. Let's have a seat. Tonight we really are blessed, and I've been looking forward to tonight to hear back from Emily. And most of you have seen Emily's face. If you don't know her, she's a member of our church who literally has grown up in this church. And I was just thinking back earlier about your baptism and what a privilege it is to be a pastor and to have shared that with you and your dad. And I remember at your grandma's house, and we baptized you, and you followed Jesus, and you've continued to follow Jesus. And it's wonderful to watch what God's done in your life. And so tonight, you get a chance to hear her story of the last 5 months. And I won't belabor the point and keep talking, but just to give you a background, she had an opportunity to go to a training school in New Zealand and then with a team on into India. Can you imagine how amazing to be able to spend 5 months out of your life just dedicated to learning more about Jesus and then preaching the gospel? And so I know there's more to come for Emily, but we want to hear about this last season. So would you come up and let us pray for you and give her a big welcome home? And let me pray for you. Jesus, we just welcome you, Holy Spirit, to now even go deeper in us, Lord. We know your presence is here, God. We sense you. We've been worshiping you, God. You're so good to us. And I pray now that you'd anoint Emily, Lord, to just share her heart, Lord, to share the takeaways of what you've brought to her, the gifts that you've given her over these last 5 months. And we're just grateful to have her home and to hear the good news. And we pray, Lord, you'd bless her tonight in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Kia ora whānau. That is hello, family, in Māori, which is the native language in New Zealand. So I was kind of excited to say that to you guys. Kia ora whānau. I'm really excited to be home. This is my home, church family. And so I was really nervous about coming up here, but then I realized, like, you guys are my family, and so I know that it's going to be good. So before I start, I was praying for tonight, and I really felt like the Lord had given me a word for somebody who's here. And so I got a picture, if we can pull that up. It's a picture of a window pane. And yeah, the Lord gave me the scripture, "Create in me a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within me." And I don't know who it's for, but I really feel like that there's somebody here that's just been looking through kind of a frosted window pane. And maybe you feel like you can't see what's on the other side, but the Lord wants you to know that he sees you. And that he sees your heart, and he wants to wipe clean the window for you so that you can see what's on the other side, and that your day has come. So, I wanted to be obedient, and whoever that's for, I hope that it resounds here in your heart. So I am excited. I want to start with my video just because I think I'm a really visual person, obviously, and I love videos, I love music and pictures, and I thought that would be more fun to start with. It's just of my last 2 months in India. Like Danny said, I got to do a discipleship training school with Youth of the Mission. And I started out in New Zealand, and then I made my way to India. So I was training for 3 months and gearing up, and then we went to India. And so I kind of wanted to show you that part of the journey first. So enjoy. Hit it, Dad.
Arrived king of these people. You're the lord of this nation. You are. You're the light in this darkness. You're the hope to the hopeless. You're the peace to the restless. You are. There is no one like our God. There is no one like our God. For greater things have yet to come, and greater things are still to be done in this.
Seems like it's just contradiction after contradiction. Things just don't make sense. Yet at the same time, in the midst of this seeming chaos, this seeming contradiction, there's so much loveliness and so much beauty and kindness.
Nothing can separate.
The little girl, Pooja, she's 8, I think. She decided to lay her idol down in the cross today.
I know I still make mistakes, but you have new mercy for me every day. Your love never fails. Singer, you stay.
Build relationship with them and just share God's love, which has been amazing, and to watch them on their journey of cutting off strings which symbolize their idols and really choosing Jesus has been amazing.
Because I know that you love me.
Yeah, just getting to hold them while they cry and pray with them. It's been amazing.
When the strong and the water's deep, I'm not alone here in these open seas. 'Cause your love never fails. The chasm was far too wide. I never thought I'd reach the other side. But your love never fails. Let's lift it up, 'cause you stay.
I remember before coming to India asking the Lord and praying and asking Him, God, I don't want to leave India the same. I want my heart to break for what breaks yours. And knowing that that was a dangerous prayer, and He did exactly that, because I don't think I'm the same person I was coming in.
India, it's nothing like I expected, but as soon as I opened my heart to it, it became really beautiful. And the culture, the people, it's just beautiful. But I know that God's not done with them yet.
It was a great joy to see that Indian people really want to know about who Jesus really is. Many people got saved.
I feel like that's pretty self-explanatory, but I really felt like I was supposed to show you that first before I gave you the background story of what led up to that, because God did some pretty amazing things in India, and I don't know how you could go to a place like that and come back the same. I get choked up every time I watch the video, because those kids were our babies and really God's gift to us. After we, you know, went through this hard journey of preparing and listening to His voice, and then going and just getting to reap the harvest. So I want to encourage you tonight, if you're waiting, that it's coming. It's So I guess if you guys don't know me, obviously my name is Emily Dembowski. My mom grew up in this church. And if you don't know my mom, then you probably know my dad, Toby. So he's on the board. So like Danny said, I've grown up in this church, and it's really good to have a place to come home to. When I was in junior high, I felt like the Lord had called me to the nations. And so ever since I graduated high school, it's kind of been my journey of going somewhere and coming back and God teaching me a whole lot of stuff and then leaving and coming home. So I'm only 20, but this is just the beginning. So I'm excited for what the Lord has in this next season. But I am so happy to be able to come back and share with you that I am a different person because of your prayers and because of your support and because you really stood behind me and prayed for me and had hope for me when I had really given up on myself. So thank you for that. When I talked to Danny earlier today, he was just kind of like, so what are you going to say? And I'm like, I don't know. And he was like, well, what are your takeaways? So when I titled my notes, it was like my three top takeaways from my experience on DTS. So my first takeaway was that God restores. And for those of you who don't know, right out of high school, I felt like the Lord was calling me to Ireland. And so I always had wanted to do Youth with a Mission. I mean, if you guys don't know, Pastor Danny did YWAM, and, you know, Naveen did YWAM. And it's just like, you know, that's what good Zion people do. They go do YWAM. So I was trying to do that, and then God said, no, I want you to go do this internship. So I did an internship in Ireland. To make a really long story short, it was nothing like I expected it would be. I came back a very, very broken person. And when, you know, in scripture they talk about the potter and holding it up to the light and to test like its true value. And well, when the Lord held me up to the light, there were cracks and there were things that he wanted to fix. So it really took, that was really a season of him breaking and shattering and really teaching me about pride and humility. And it was a real growth experience. But also, while that's going on, I got very, very physically ill. So I had to come home early, and you all welcomed me with open arms. And so I came back, and I was just like, okay, I'm never leaving again. I can't do it. God, I know you call me to be a missionary, but I can't. I love it here, and this is safe, and this is where I'm comfortable, and it's good. And the Lord said to me, Emily, I didn't call you here. I called you to the nations. And are you going to obey me, or are you going to be disobedient? So when I had surgery and did all that and was finally listening to God's voice again, he's like, okay, I'm calling you out. And I was like, no. But he was like, but on the plus side, I'm, you know, going to lead you to do a DTS. So I was like, fine. So I finally said yes, and that's how I ended up in New Zealand. Thanks to all of your guys' support as well. Just, it was a journey of wrestling and saying, no, God, I can't. I failed in New Zealand, in Northern Ireland, and I can't go to New Zealand. And him being like, no, I'm your hope, and I'm the thing that you've got to hold on to. And I like wrote down a bazillion scriptures today, but it was just, he said in Psalm 33:22, may your unfailing love be with us, Lord, even as we put our hope in you. Psalm 42:5, why, my soul, are you downcast? Why so disturbed within me? Put your hope in God, for I will yet praise him, my Savior and my God. And then Romans 5:5, and hope does not put us to shame because God's love has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit who has been given us. And that was really something that I didn't know leaving home, was that God had a future and a plan for my life. And that he was going to give me hope again. And so when I went, it was a huge process of healing and him taking me away and showing me how much he loved me, which was an amazing revelation. You would think I would know that growing up in the church, but I knew it in my head, but I didn't know it in my heart that he loved me. And so I guess for you, I want to say that if to ask for that revelation, if it's just head knowledge, he wants it to be so much more for you. That he loves you, that he loves you, that he loves you, that he loves you, and he has a future and a hope and a plan for your life. Because if he could do it for me, I guarantee you he can do it for you, because I can be pretty stubborn sometimes. You can ask my family. So I went to New Zealand. I got a whānau, a family, and they walked alongside me as I, for those of you guys who don't know what celiacs is, it's a lot of food allergies, pretty much. We can just put it at that. But they walked alongside me and were there with me as I was doing classes and trying to figure out, you know, coming out of class to lunch and being like, I can't eat anything that's on the table, and getting sick and being accidentally poisoned a couple times. And, you know, they really encouraged me on my walk to keep pressing in, to keep fighting for my healing. And I've had so many people pray over me. Just, you know what I mean? They're like, you know, Emily, your healing's coming. And it's not just me, but my family, my entire family. You know, we've got a whole laundry list of stuff. We go to the doctors and they're like, so, you know, what do you have? And you're like, well, I've got this and I've got this and then my heart and then I've got this. And, you know, and it's each of us. So for me going into this school, they're like, so do you have any medical problems we need to know about? And I was like, well, maybe yes. But even when I didn't have any hope that God was going to heal me or anything like that, they did, and they continued to pray for me. And so I guess that's my second takeaway, is that I learned that God was my healer. And I kept getting these scriptures over and over again. All the speakers would come in and they would walk up to me. There were only 8 of us students, so you can imagine we got picked on a whole lot. And so a speaker would walk up to me, he'd be like, I feel like I'm supposed to tell you, taste and see that the Lord is good. And I'd be like, oh, okay. Well, for a girl who can't eat anything, and I mean, I really couldn't eat anything, that was a pretty odd scripture to keep getting over and over and over again. And so I was like, all right. And then finally, I think it was like week 5 or 6, and it's like a 12-week lecture phase, the speaker came right up to me with a fork. He had cake on the end of it, and which had like 5 ingredients in it that I was allergic to at the time. And he was like, I feel like you're supposed to eat this piece of cake and taste and see that the Lord is good. And all of my friends who have been there the whole time listening to every single speaker come in and tell me this, they're like, yeah, eat the cake. And I'm just like, I was kind of like, no, you're crazy, because every single doctor I'd been to had said there's no cure, and I knew the consequences. I knew that stepping out in faith in that way meant either I wasn't going to get sick or I was going to be violently ill and miss the rest of his lectures. So I didn't take the bite of cake, but a couple weeks later, my leaders really challenged me to take that step of faith, because I wouldn't know if I'd been healed or not had I not eaten something. So I was just kind of living in this limbo of like, oh, I'm not healed, or I might be healed. It's possible. And it was, I did eat during lecture, and I got sick. And then the next time someone prayed over me, I ate again and got a little bit less sick. And then again, and I got a little bit less sick. And it was definitely a journey that God had to walk me on, because it wasn't one of those things where people laid hands on me and, you know, I mean, I know that happens to people and that's amazing. Like, that is an amazing testimony. But for me, God was teaching me something through it. Like, do you trust me? And I was like, yes, Lord, I trust you. And even if I get sick, I still trust you. And I still believe that you're going to complete the good work in me that you've started. So we, you know, did all the intercession praying and getting ready. By this time, we know what our teams are, and we're getting excited. We're going to India, and we were there was a team going to Tahiti, and there was a team going to Indonesia and Christchurch, and then India. So we were going the farthest. So we were just kind of like, okay, and I'm thinking about, okay, I got to pack all this food, and I've got to, you know, have all these medicines, and I was going to doctors and getting medications and things like that for all the bazillion things that I thought would probably go wrong. And so I arrive in India, and the only thing to eat there for 3 days, the first 3 days, was toast. And so it was one of those things where I was like, God, you're so funny. You're hilarious. You want me to starve. And so the first day, my leader's like, Em, you've got to eat. And so I was like, okay. So I make myself a peanut butter and jelly, and we like stuck our fingers on it and prayed over it, and then I ate it. And then the next day, we did the same thing, and then the next day, and until it got to the point where a couple days later, my leader's just kind of like, Em, have you been sick? And I said, no, I haven't. And she's like, that's interesting. And I had been eating everything that they had been putting in front of me without asking any questions. And so it was after that that we began to experiment. And so we would run down to the shop and buy biscuits because they drink tea all the time. And so I would like eat the whole package of biscuits, and we would just wait. And nothing happened. And so I guess that was a huge, huge takeaway for me, was that I can stand here saying that I have been healed of all of my food allergies. If you guys don't know what fibromyalgia is, it seems to be taking over this area. A lot of people are getting diagnosed with it. I haven't had any FM symptoms in 2 months. Actually, over two. So it's almost been 3 months since I've had any symptoms. So, yeah, it's amazing to stand here and say that that our God is a healer. And, yeah, before I could say that for other people, because, you know, he would call me to pray over people, and I'd be like, God's going to heal you. And then I would walk away and wouldn't believe it for myself. But now I can stand here and say that God is our healer, and I am a living testimony of that. So I even went and saw my doctors when I came home, and you know, I've been having appointments, and they're like, you really are healed. You know, they've been, you know, checking different things, putting the machines that they would normally put on me, and I'm, you know, way beyond normal and everything. And so they're like, wow, you know. And so it's been an amazing God story, that He's good, and that he always fulfills his promises. And I think that's really a testimony too of all of your prayers, because when I came home and was so sick, you know, you guys really did come around me and pray for me, and I didn't know what was going on, and I had doctors were telling me I was crazy. And I want to thank you, because you're a part of my story today, that I get to stand up here and say, I can eat everything now. So thank you, because it really is. You guys are a part of that journey with me these last 2 years. So I guess my third point is that I am an overcomer of fear in him. And I know to you that probably doesn't make any sense. Like, how does she go from healer to overcomer of fear? But But when I had arrived in India, that was exactly what I had to overcome in order to eat the forbidden fruit, was my fear. And I think that was another word that our lecturers and teachers and people that would come in and speak to us, they were like, I just need you to know that you are an overcomer. And I'm like, oh, great. An overcomer of what? And, you know, it was really, the Lord was like, I want to remove the spirit of fear out of your life. And it was something that I've struggled with ever since I was really little. I used to get really bad nightmares. And even in high school, like, I would get nightmares all the time. And I've always been pretty sensitive to spiritual stuff. And so going to a place like India, you can't really be scared of spiritual stuff. We stepped off the plane, and immediately there's idols right there before you go into customs. And I'm with my friend Kat, who was in the video, and I look over at the idol, and it moved and, like, watched me and then winked at me. And I was like, did you just see that? Did you just see that? And I still get chills when I think about the fact that I was there. And because until that point, spiritual stuff was just what we, like, it was here in church. In the OC, we don't deal with that kind of stuff. We don't see it manifested before our eyes. And I'd always been terrified of spiritual stuff and demons. And the Lord was trying to drag me along and say, greater is he who is in you than he who is in the world. And so what, for me, my healing came when I released my fear. When I said, okay, God, you can have it. I'm tired of living my life the way that it is, living inside my little box of I can't do this and I can do that, and, you know, I'll only be this good at something, and realizing that God was like, no, I've called you to so much more than that. And I went there, and I was terrified of cars. I was terrified of, I guess, moving vehicles and, like, demons and different things like that. I had a whole list of things that I was very afraid of, and every single one were smack in my face in India. So my healing continued in India, obviously, not just the first week of realizing that I could eat everything, but surrendering and being like, okay, Lord, I give you my fear of heights. And literally that day I would be on this bridge doing this, like, yes, Jesus, you're amazing, you know, and don't look down. But it was just, it was amazing, because I can walk in so much more freedom now. And I stand here saying that not because I think that I'm such a cool person or that I'm good at all that kind of stuff, because I'm human. I'm saying that because you can overcome those strongholds in your life that are keeping you from living. Amen. Those things that are holding you back from stepping into all that God's called you. Even something as simple as talking to the woman in front of you at the grocery store and saying, God, I can't do that because I might offend her, or whatever it is. I don't know. You know what I mean? I don't know what it is for you. For me, it was fear. It was the whole getting into a car and trusting that the vehicle wasn't going to get smashed, you know, or, you know, getting pushed out of a moving train or things like that. Some crazy things happened to me, but, I am a more than a conqueror in him, and so are you. And so those promises that I read in his word hold true in my life, but also in yours. And so I guess that's a pretty amazing takeaway, to realize that you don't have to live your life in fear of man, of anything. I mean, I know that we've been studying Jeremiah and precepts and talking about the fear of the Lord and just really God's wrath. And, you know, you kind of need the bad news for the good news to really be good. And so for me, I my heart was that I could show you that I went through this really dark season of my life, but I've come out on the other side, and I'm a different person because of the work that he's done in me these last 5 months. And so I'm so thankful. I'm so beyond thankful because he's good. I mean, really, there's no other words to say, like, besides the fact that he's good. And I know that when you're young and you're, well, okay, let's see, I was only in high school 2 years ago, but when you're in high school, it's kind of hard to go outside your bubble of your friends and talk to people or step out in obedience, because sometimes we just don't want to listen. And I'm saying that because I know, because that's how I live. So I'm not saying you do that per se, but I want to encourage you to not hold back, because each one of you is so powerful. And I'm like, I mean, I say that to all of you guys, but I really want to say that to my generation and the generation behind me, that you guys are so powerful. You guys have no idea. Because if God could use me in a place like India, and I know you guys had an amazing experience in Honduras, he wants to do huge things in your life. Can you imagine if he could use you to change a nation, what you could do in your schools, what you could do in your homes, in this city, in this nation? Because I know that God's shaking things up. I think that's one thing in having traveled and been, you know what I mean, going through this walk of being with, like, listening to the Lord's voice and getting to spend all this quiet time, and it's pretty much cut out for you, so it's pretty structured, to coming home and feeling everything that's here and what the Lord's wanting to do in that anticipation. And I just, like, I'm like, yes, let's jump on that train, because I can feel it. I can see, like, hear it coming almost. And I'm so excited because to be a part of this church, because I feel like you're all in the same boat. You're all like, yes, let's go. You can hear it coming. And I just want to say, hold on, because I don't think we're going to miss it. As a church, like, I think that, I mean, I'm not saying thus saith the Lord, but I know that God's got some pretty big things for Zion. And that we're already touching our city, but I think that he's going to start to branch us out, and that it's going to keep reaching. And that's because of us as a body. That's because of each one of you and the callings that he has on each one of your lives and the specific gifts that he has for you, that he wants to give you, that he wants to grow inside each one of you. I mean, I can't tell you how many prophetic words you all gave to me that led me to this point. Because I definitely was fighting, going, and you guys would come up to me and be like, I feel like the Lord's saying, and I'm like, no, don't tell me that. Okay, God, three more confirmations. And because God loves me that much, and because of your obedience, he did. He brought up three more of you, and you gave me those words, and I thank you for that. And I want to encourage you, if God does speak to you and give you words and pictures, to step out, especially the youth. I know that's intimidating, but do it. Seriously, you won't regret it, because even if it's scary and it's for the whole church, Danny will stop you if it's crazy. And because the Lord speaks to us too. I love that scripture. Do not let anyone look down on you because you are young, but set an example for the believers in speech, in life, in love, in faith, and in purity. And I think that the Lord is calling us as a younger generation to be that example of purity and to take that stand and say, no, this is not okay. And this is what the Lord says, and this is why I live my life differently. And I know that all of our mommies and daddies out here are cheering us on in that. And I have to say that we've got a pretty rich heritage here at Zion. Use them. Please do. Please talk to them. Because they're pretty amazing. Just saying. And I want to encourage you guys who have been obedient and who have spoken into my life, taught me in Sunday school and everything. I wouldn't be the woman I am today if it weren't for you. So thank you. Almost. Thank you so much. I really want to encourage you that whatever it is that you're going through, whatever it is that you're walking through, that he sees you and that he's with you and he's always speaking and he's always moving. He loves you guys way more than the rest of us could ever love you, but he loves you. So I just want to remind you that. I know you know that, but I felt like I was supposed to remind you. So I guess in closing, I can say that, well, more than anything, I hope if you take away anything, it's that it's worth being still in his presence. And I feel like worship lined up with everything that was like in my little bullet point notes. Because I know myself and I will just read my notes because I get nervous in front of people. But to be still in his presence because he is speaking and he is trying to say something. And I didn't want to come up here and show you all these fancy pictures and be like, oh my gosh, look at this crazy place that I went to. I mean, God did some pretty amazing things just in that open air that you saw. 20 people got saved. And I say that because I wouldn't have been able to go without you guys. So I want you to know that there's 20 more people that are going to be joining us up in heaven that are going to probably shake your hand and be like, you helped, you know, bring those missionaries over to us. But right now, for today, I know that God wants to bring his glory. I want to give him glory for my testimony and my story, but I also know that he's wanting to say something. And he wants to set you free, whether it's from fear or you need physical healing or you're in bondage because of whatever it is. I want to like make myself available. I know that Danny and Scott and all of our amazing pastors, they're available too. I want to give you the opportunity. Please come and talk to us. We want to pray for you. I want to pray for you. I got to pray over a woman. I was only in New Zealand 6 days after India. And a woman pulled me aside and she was like, I need you to pray for me. I've got food allergies. And I got to pray over her. And that's an amazing story. And before I left, I haven't spoken with her since, but she was like, Em, I think I'm healed. And I'm so humbled that the Lord would use me in that way. And so I want to open it up that if you need prayer, please don't leave tonight not getting it. Please don't leave. Because even if you just sit in his presence, just here, be still and know that he's God. He's a good God. And he wants to set you free tonight. He doesn't want you to leave carrying the same baggage that you walked in with. And I know because when I went to New Zealand, I used to tease my leaders. I was like, I've got a bunch of luggage. And I physically had a lot of luggage because I carried a lot of food. But like just emotionally, I was like, I've got a lot of baggage for a girl raised in a church. And they were just like, that's okay. We're going to unpack it. And so I want to tell you that tonight's the night to unpack it all and leave it here. So, and I can say that with confidence because I know the Lord's doing something and that he's here. So thank you so much just for listening and being patient with me. I don't have a whole lot of experience speaking in front of people, so I thank you for listening and being so attentive. I do. I really do love you guys, and I've been praying for you, and it's really good to be home for however long it's going to be. It's been good to be home, so thank you, and thank you, Washingtonian family. I love you, too. So, yeah, thank you so much.
So Emily's got us all fooled when she says she's not used to speaking in front of people, because she just did an amazing job, right? Yeah. You know, I just want to really confirm the things that she said and really give us an opportunity. Now, she said, don't leave this place without receiving prayer. And just in my heart, as I was sitting here, I think of the principle of impartation, right? When the Apostle Paul went somewhere, he had something to give, right? And no doubt you've already received. She's had something to give to you tonight. And I just want to seal that in prayer. And I'm going to ask Emily to pray for us. And I want you to hear my heart. I want to challenge. I think for the youth, it's one perspective to go, wow, that's Emily. She's older than us. And, you know, how awesome. And you would admire her. I think there's a different challenge for those of you that have watched her grow up in this church. And I want you to hear my heart when I say this. It's the challenge to go, how sweet that that happened. Do you hear what I mean? To say like, wow, that's really neat for her. But the challenge for you tonight is to say, Jesus is speaking through her to me tonight. Do you follow me? That regardless of your age and regardless of the experiences and you know, there's family members here and there's people in Washington listening, and you know, but that you would receive what Jesus wants to give, because she's been so faithful to deliver it. It's like she broke bread for us tonight and said, here's part of my life, and here's what Jesus has done for me, and here's what he wants to do for you. And so my challenge now in this point in our service is to forget the messenger in some ways and hear the message, right? Hear Jesus through Emily. And so whether you have just met her tonight, whether you're part of Joy Renewed, part of the youth, or you've known Emily since she was pregnant in her mommy's tummy, that we wouldn't let familiarity rob us of the word of the Lord tonight. And so I want to invite us all to stand to our feet and really engage God's presence. And there were three things that I heard tonight, amongst many other things. But one, that God is madly in love with each one of us. I had a testimony this week in my office of someone who said, I've followed the Lord my whole life, but it wasn't until 15 years ago when I sat in a teaching that I understood the love of God. And this is a grown, godly man. And maybe you need a revelation of God's love tonight. Well, we're going to pray that you receive a revelation of God's love. I also heard that God wants to heal physically, that there are some who have been holding out for a miracle from God, and God wants to do that. You just witnessed somebody who has been healed physically. There's an authority that she carries because of that, and also an impartation that, here, take it, right? That's what impartation means. What I have, I give. And then the third thing is that you've heard a word of the Lord that he wants to deliver us from all of our fears. And I got to tell you that there isn't anybody that's flesh and blood that doesn't have some kind of fear. So that's a word for all of us. But some of us are literally chained by that fear, and we don't want anybody to know it. And this is between you and the Lord tonight. But that God would free you and break the chains and the binds of fear, that he would release you into the fullness of what he has for you. Fear is such a debilitating disease. It just stops us from everything, causing us to second guess and worry and not enabling us to put one foot in front of the other. We can be that locked into a cage with fear. And so whether it's a revelation of God's love, a healing that he wants to impart to you, or a freedom from fear, wouldn't it be just like God to break those things tonight? And it isn't God powerful enough to do it all by himself, just like that. So where your faith is, go with it. Go with where your faith is. But I'm going to ask Emily just to pray over us, and I would encourage you to receive from the Lord tonight.
Okay. Yeah. Holy Spirit, I just want to invite you to come and be with us. Yeah, Lord, I just thank you so much that you are our healer. God, and that you love us so much. You already did the work on the cross. And I thank you for that. So right now, I just want to speak to the fear. I rebuke it in Jesus' name. I want to bind you, Satan, and tell you to flee right now in Jesus' name. Lord, I pray that these people, my family, that they would feel the chains just being broken even now. That they would be able to dust off their feet and walk in that freedom. Lord, I just pray for your healing anointing right now to come over us. May your glory fall, Lord. I just want to speak physical healing in Jesus' name. If you suffer from headaches or from body aches or pain or maybe addictions or even heartache, those things that no one else sees, I just speak healing to them right now in Jesus' name. And I want to speak to each spirit and say, you are free. Your days of living in insecurity and fear are numbered. Lord, I just thank you so much that we can live 100% free of fear in you, 100% free of insecurity, that we can step out in faith knowing that we're not just stepping out of the boat onto to water, but we're stepping out onto you. Lord, I just thank you so much. I pray for a fresh revelation of your love, that you would rekindle that fire. Lord, that fire that may be so dim that we can't even feel it anymore, or maybe it's been burning brighter than ever. I just ask for more right now in Jesus' name. Holy Spirit, that you would grow gifts and you would begin to give them visions and dreams and that people would move in the prophetic, Lord God. I thank you that you are doing something new and we can see it coming. Thank you, Lord. I just thank you for your promises. I thank you that your plans for us are good and they're to prosper us and not to harm us. To give us a hope and a future. And so I just claim that for this church, for this body, for each and every one of us here, that we would be able to walk in your love because your perfect love casts out all fear. So I thank you, Lord, that today we can walk in that freedom. I thank you that today we are free, today we are healed, and today we have a deeper understanding of your love. We love you and praise you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Let me just pray as well. Father, we receive tonight, and I speak this on behalf of you, but you have to own it yourself. God, we receive the word of the Lord to us. God, we receive that which has been imparted. God, we honor the message that you've brought, Lord, and we even honor the messenger. Lord, we thank you for Emily's faithfulness, Lord, and for her obedience tonight to share from her heart. And God, we receive the words that have been spoken as words that come from you. And Jesus, we would pray, Lord, that you would not only allow us to receive this word, but hide this word in our heart, that we would walk out of this sanctuary changed people, that we would walk out with the seeds of truth sown into our heart, that you are madly in love with us. God, with the seeds of truth sown into our heart, that you are a healer. With the seed of truth sown into our heart, that you will free us from every fear and bondage. And God, that those seeds would grow and just bear fruit in our lives. Bless your people tonight, God, and we receive what's been spoken, and we honor you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Hey, I heard Emily say she's willing to pray for others, and we are too. So if you need prayer, take us up on that. And God bless you all. Thank you, Emily. Yeah.
There's a little clip at the end of the video, so we'll just play it while you guys are leaving. The kids, I filmed them for my sister's birthday, but I was like, this is for a thank you video for aunties and uncles in the USA. And they were like, okay. So I will play the end of that clip. And yes, please come get prayer. So God bless you.
Thank you, Emily.
Great job, Emily.
Hi.
18, I have my first love. There was nobody that compared to my baby, and nobody came between us, no could ever come above. She had me going crazy, oh, I was starstruck. She woke me up daily, don't need no Starbucks. She made my heart pound and skip a beat when I see her in the street and at school on the playground. But I really wanna see her on the weekend. She knows she got me dazing, cause she was so amazing. And now my heart is breaking, but I just keep on saying,
thank you.